I want to solve my problems. The way to do it is to turn to your maker. And you cannot turn to your maker unless you are compassionate towards the rest of the creatures of the same maker. Subhanallah. We're seated here this afternoon. What connects us? A lot of things. Primarily, we've been created by the same maker. We're going to go back to the same maker. Subhanallah. We belong to Allah, don't we? When someone passes away, no matter who they are, what do we say? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Don't we say that? Oh. And when someone we didn't expect, well, everyone passes away, but someone suddenly, oh, gone. Inna lillahi. So it said a little bit louder, right? It said with a little bit more expression. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi. Same thing you're saying. What does it mean? It means we belong to Allah and we're all going to return to Him. So don't be deceived. Going to return to Allah. When you return to Allah, will it matter? Will it matter what car you were driving? Will it matter what designers you had? Will it matter what shoes you had? Will it matter? Subhanallah, where you bought that from? When there are people struggling to find a little bit of fresh water to drink. May Allah Almighty bless us. So this story of Yusuf alayhi salam, the reason why I decided to repeat some of the points is because it happens in our lives. Don't despair. Allah is great. Your life, inshallah, will be coming up with much goodness, much successes, one after the other. Lots of victories that you don't notice. They go unnoticed because we're concentrating on the challenges. We've met in this particular venue or at this venue a few times, some of us. And I promise you one statement that so many people have come back to me and said, you know, this was a game changer. Was that, and I'm saying it again because the benefit of those who haven't heard it. Did you know that Allah promises you, He guarantees you, that if you try to count His favors on you, you are never going to be able to count them. He guarantees that. But if you would like to count the challenges He's put in your life, you will be able to count them. Have you ever thought of that? If I ask you, how's life? You have a choice. We normally say, Alhamdulillah, even if you're in a big mess, mashallah, may Allah grant us ease. But usually, you choose to either speak about the positives or the negatives. A believer is supposed to say, Alhamdulillah, because you are concentrating on the positives. But sometimes we are weak, we are man, and we start complaining, you know, oh, there's this challenge and that challenge. Think about it. Write your challenges in this book. I promise you, you won't fill the page. That's how many challenges there will be. Probably 5, 10, what else? You failed your exam, that's one. You went through a divorce, that's the other. You lost one loved one, that's a third one. What else? These are big things, but you can count them, can't you? Right? You lost a job. What's the other? You have a certain health matter that you're dealing with. What's the other? Five things. Okay. What else? What about the favors of Allah upon you? Oh. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. What a verse. Allah says, if you try and count the favors of Allah upon you, no chance. You are not going to manage and succeed. You won't be able to count the favors of Allah. That's why I say, my brothers, my sisters, these challenges in your lives and mine, they're temporary, number one. They're limited, number two. And number three, as a result of those, your path to that victory will be flung open. Had it not been for some of what you've been through, you would never taste the victory that's in your path. People have been divorced once, twice, then they get married to a king, mashallah, or a queen, and they're so excited, and 30 years down the line they say, you know what, had it not been for this, I wouldn't have been here where I am. But there are others who gave up after the first knock. Gave up. Don't give up. Life is still, mashallah, we don't have a guarantee, but we have to keep living. So my brothers, my sisters, I pray that these few words I've said would actually help us look forward to navigate through the challenges that Allah throws in our direction. And we look at them as opportunities to gain closeness to Allah. We become closer to Allah. We're happy upon all these conditions. Yusuf alayhi salam was happy when he was in the well. He was happy when they removed him. He was happy when they sold him. He was happy when they accused him. He was happy when they decided to jail him. He was happy in the jail. He was happy when they forgot him in the jail for some years. And he was happy when he came out. And subhanAllah, that was the ultimate success. His brothers kept on saying this and that and whatever until the last minute when they saw, whoa, this was something crazy. We planned the downfall of this person, and it was through our plan of his downfall, Allah decided to raise him above all of us. They realized it. They sought forgiveness.